Fuerte.
They love you. What can I say?
I think it's you that they love.
No, it's Wednesday, yeah. January 4th, 2012. My co-host today is David Duchovny. And all is right with the world.
Oh, that's
welcome home. I feel like saying welcome home to you because this is like your second home.
It is. Well, it was my first home.
Your first home, right?
I grew up here, and now it is my only home, really.
So when you shoot your TV show, where do you shoot that?
Shoot in California.
So you go there.
So I've lied already. That's my second home. I go there for about 3 or 4 months of the year so far, for 5 years, yeah.
And do you get to go when the weather's... I guess the weather's always good there.
Yeah, it's always good. I would prefer if we got to shoot this time of year.
Yeah.
You know, while it's 7 degrees outside.
Right, exactly. You
know. But we've been going in April to June, pretty much. April to July.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, you're missing the best time here.
It's a big mistake.
Yeah, it is. But can't you fix that? Aren't you the star of the show?
You know what? You're giving me a good idea. I'm going to take care of that when we're done.
Write all of that down.
I hadn't realized I was the star of the show until you mentioned that.
Well, you are. You are the star of that show. And trust us, we love that show.
Oh. Thank you.
There are children in the audience, and you're not allowed to applaud that show. You do not love that show.
Yes, sometimes people will come up to me on the street, and they'll have an 8-year-old with them, and they'll say, he's your biggest fan. He loves the show so much. And I say, you should probably get in touch with Child Services.
Well, that's probably from The X-Files.
No, I think it's Californication.
Really?
Yeah.
You think 8-year-olds are watching that?
I hope not.
Oh, my God.
I'm telling you, these are parents. You know, they wanted a picture with me. I says, this child has no idea who I am, I'm hoping.
Yeah, right, of course.
Yeah.
I like that, too. Sometimes people will say, my son is your biggest fan.
Right.
Can he have a picture with you? And the little boy's like, Mom, who is that? Mom, who is that?
Or then there are the adults that say, I'm your biggest fan, can I have a picture, and what's your name?
Yeah, right,
yeah,
exactly.
That's always complimentary.
Did you watch any of the caucus results come in last night?
No, but I woke up this morning, and I got on the computer, and I saw that this was an 8-vote difference.
Yeah,
is that
no,
right?
It's an 8. You know how they say every vote counts?
Yeah.
Turns out they're not kidding about that.
But
8-vote difference.
What is a caucus as opposed to a primary?
Okay.
Or an election?
Does anybody know? This just basically helps decide who people are going to put their money behind for primaries. Is that right?
Well, the caucus is a complicated...
Is anybody an American in here? Anybody in America? How many Supreme Court justices are there?
They all vote in person.
They all vote, right.
No,
yes.
You don't know. He's just going like this.
No, this is what they do. This is what they do.
They go to different people.
Take a shot of the panel
like
of
this.
Experts.
They go
There's
like
the
this.
Panel of experts. And they stare at you blankly, and then occasionally they'll go this.
Yeah.
And then they'll do something like this.
Yeah. It's like, it's a little like this, actually.
So this is what it means, everybody.
This is a caucus. This is a primary. Caucus. Primer. I'm an American citizen. I know that because I served on jury duty this year. For the first time. Well, I shouldn't say that.
I did that last year. Tell me. How was your experience?
Well, I'll tell you what I learned from jury duty is that you should never break the law.
Right.
Because I didn't want to be my fate to be decided by the people that I was hanging out with.
My fate decided by my peers because I don't think that my peers are particularly rational.
There were some interesting questions being asked.
Yeah, like what? Tell me. Give me like the top three.
Well, they were trying to pick a jury, and first of all, the defendant. I don't know why they picked the jury in front of the defendant. First of all, he winks at me when I walk in there, and I was thinking, please dismiss me. He knows who I am.
Right, we are practically brothers.
But I can't. What if I say that he's guilty and now he knows who I am and he wants to come and take his revenge on me? That's a TV movie all of a sudden.
Right.
But they don't dismiss me. And then the defense attorney says to one of the prospective witnesses, he says, would you have any trouble attributing motive to anybody? And she says, well, I don't know. And he says, well, if I said I'm thirsty and then I take a sip of water, Would you say that my motive was because I was thirsty?
Oh my God, I am so confused by that question. I would say dismiss me. Right. I lack the mental capacity to understand what you're saying.
And she said, well, I don't know that. You could have been trying to stall.
Is that what she said?
Yes, and I'm there.
Oh my God, she made it onto the jury, didn't she?
Well, I don't know. That's when I decided I was never going to break the law again.
Here's what I would do. I would just go there and say, he looks guilty to me. And then aren't you, like, immediately dismissed?
You can be, but you could also say, he looks guilty and thirsty at the same time.
I feel like, you know how they say, your chances of being called for jury duty and winning the lottery are like equal.
Oh, are they?
But I feel like I am called for jury duty once a year or once every 2 years, and I've never won the lottery, even though I don't play the lottery.
It?
But
they say you have to be in it to win it.
I know, but
that's,
I know that if
that's
I
what I've heard,
if
anyway.
I was in it, I wouldn't win. I know,
no.
I wouldn't.
My son, it's illegal. I know that. He's only 9, but he loves to play the scratch off.
But then he would pass it to you if he won, and then you would cash it in. Right.
I have to cash it in.
Oh, so he's won.
Well, you know, you win. It's a scam. No.
It's
not a scam at all. But it's addictive in the sense that most often you win another card. You know, that's what.
Oh,
they
is
do.
That true?
Yeah.
That you win it. Oh.
The cheaper ones. You know, they keep you coming back.
Right. But once in a while, I've given,
it's like... like this.
Yeah. I will give lottery cards with Christmas gifts, and once in a while, I've had friends that have, like, won a couple $100, and they're like, thanks, that was so great. I just thought I was getting, you know, that the crappy holiday box of candy, and then it turns out $200 with it.
How about that?
Yeah.
News alert. You know, Kelly,
this is breaking news, everyone.
Nothing says Christmas quite like a bunch of lottery tickets.
What is it? This is caucus versus primary. What's the difference?
Okay.
Yeah.
So who says that we don't educate here?
Yeah.
Kids, write this down.
I can't read the type anymore.
Oh, my God.
I need a magnifying glass. Everybody... I think
with
this
caucus,
is fine.
With the caucus and primary, boys, all the men, do your sign language while I do this. With the caucus and primary season underway, we had a discussion in the newsroom about the differences between the two and realized even some of our staff didn't realize some of the nuances. That's why we went to an expert to explain how each system works. Primaries and caucuses are set up in different ways in each state, but have general distinctions, according to the University of Maine political science professor
Everybody's
Mark
Brew. Asleep.
No, they're writing this down. They're writing this down because this is probably going to be our trivia question tomorrow. Brewer said primaries are similar to general elections. Voters cast secret ballots at polling places and can come and go as they please. Caucuses, however, are longer time commitments.
Can I have some alcohol in this?
There's already vodka in that, I made sure. Voters have to stay throughout the duration of caucus, whether it lasts 15 minutes or several hours, and the votes are in person, face-to-face, and often involve discussions. Make sure we don't go to Iowa anytime soon. So those eight votes really came down to
together.
Something.
It's
more like this.
They got together. Holy cow. That's amazing. So on Monday's show, you weren't here, but we discussed the fact that Mayor Bloomberg and Lady Gaga shared a kiss when the ball dropped. And I, of course, didn't think it was a big deal because I really didn't see any chemistry between the two of them. But Mayor Bloomberg has, like, issued a statement. Mayor Bloomberg has issued a statement saying that he would be remiss if he didn't say that the best kiss of the night came after his kiss to Lady Gaga from his girlfriend, Diana Taylor. Mr. Mayor, we didn't know you were such a softy. Good for Mr. Mayor.
And he said, in no way did Diana Taylor ask me to write this text.
Written by Diana Taylor.
I was told, too.
Funny, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, there's the kiss again. Yes, I can't get enough of it. We keep showing it over and over again, trying to make it look like a longer kiss than it actually was.
Well, maybe they had that electricity thing where, you know,
where
the
they
bad
got stuck together.
They might have gotten static electricity.
Does anybody get that when you run on the treadmill? Do your earbuds shock you in your inner ear? Yes, it does. Okay, it's not just me then. Okay. All right, good. Because I keep getting shocked on the treadmill when I run. My earbuds, like, zap me all of a sudden.
Earbuds is an odd word. You keep on repeating earbuds.
Well, you know, there's headphones.
And then there's earbuds.
Look at the difference in color between my unmade-up hands and my face. Do you think I'm wearing a lot of makeup?
Wow.
Does anybody think I'm wearing a lot of makeup?
You wear gloves in the sun.
I do. I'm wearing white gloves right now. Just FYI. Do you have pets?
Yes, I have two cats and only one dog left. My dogs keep dying.
Yeah. Oh, what happened?
Old age.
Old age.
Yeah. I had my dog Blue for 17 years.
Oh my gosh! Yeah. So your dog was like a family member.
Yes, she was.
So you would say that your pet has a soul.
Oh, yes, definitely. Right. Which is interesting. I'll tell you a quick story. When I was traveling in Thailand right after college, I was having a discussion with an old wise man, and he was saying that when you get sick, we human beings have 9 souls or something like that. When you get sick, you've lost one and it has to come back to your body. And I said, oh, interesting. Do dogs have souls? And he said, oh, yeah, dogs have 4 souls. Do pigs have souls? Yeah, your pigs have 2 souls. You know? And I said, well, what about chickens? And he said, we don't know yet.
Yes.
That's
serious?
That's absolutely true.
No kidding.
The research is not back on chickens and souls, so they're waiting. Perhaps this was in 1983, so they might know by now.
You should go back and
find
out.
Do you think chickens have souls? I mean, I don't know.
Yeah,
see,
sure.
It's controversial.
Yeah,
nobody knows.
We don't want to think of something we eat by the bucket as having a soul. Because what would that make us, right?
Yeah.
It's very, you know, while we were away, there was a death in the family. And I don't want to name names, so I'm going to talk in code, but a certain member of our family won a certain pet at a carnival in a bowl when he threw the ping pong bowl into the thing,
right,
the water.
Right.
And let's all face it, from July 4th until January, that's quite a long life for that kind of pet. Right?
Yes.
I really didn't think it would make it through the night after I carried it in a plastic bag around the carnival.
Normally you don't think of horses living that long.
So anyway, I get a phone call that said pet has gone on to a better place.
Yeah.
And so I start panicking, and we've got to get one that looks like that one in the tank.
Right.
And so...
You're giving away too many details.
I know. He's in school, and I'm confident that nobody's going to see this.
Right.
But so he starts talking to me on the plane ride home. What about Brucikins? And I said, what about him? And he says, well,
Brucikins.
I have a feeling that something bad happened to him. I just have this feeling. Because
first thing that bad happened was his name, Brucikins.
It's a family name.
Yeah,
it's a beautiful
right.
family
right.
name.
Right.
And he says, I just have a feeling that something bad happened to him. Because I swear on my life, this is a fish that responded to my son. When he would walk into the room, the fish would come over and like be like, oh my gosh, you're here. And they had like, yes.
No.
And so in we walk, and there's the replacement Brucikins, and we can all agree that although it looks similar, it's definitely not Brucikins. And so third child comes in and right away says, I mean, makes a beeline to the fish tank and says, no, that's not him.
Really?
And I was like, no, that's him. He goes, he looks smaller. He looks a lot smaller. And I said, well, you know, you haven't been here you haven't been here in a couple of weeks, so right. Maybe he's not as well fed as he normally is. And he's
perhaps his New Year's resolution was to lose a...
like so many of us.
I'm going to lose 3 ounces.
Anyway, so I feel very, you know...
Brucekins on Atkins.
But Brucekins...
So I'm going to continue. Stop me. So what happened?
I feel like Brucekins has a soul.
Oh, you do? You feel like he has a soul?
I feel like even that little goldfish has a soul because he would get so excited to see Joaquin when he walked in the bedroom. Like, well, he would get so excited.
Honestly, I feel like every living thing has a soul.
Well, there's a lawsuit. This woman is saying that her puppy has a soul, and she bought this puppy from a pet store, and the puppy's been suffering ever since. It's got, like, joint problems, and right. It can't walk, and it cries out in agony. So she's suing the pet store for, I'm not sure, for pain and suffering, and based on the fact that whether or not a pet has a soul is going to be one of the sticking issues of this lawsuit. But I think most pet owners would say, absolutely, my pet is like a person in our family.
Yeah. However, I don't think you should be able to. I don't think the court of law should be deciding that, especially the people that I served on the jury.
Right. Right. A jury of the peers would be like a jury of dogs.
Yeah, right. Exactly.
I smell a Disney film. Anyway, we've got a big show today.
Yes,
are you ready?
Yes.
On today's show, Terrence Howard is here from the new film Red Tail.
And our New Year's Fitness Week continues when we try out Brooke Burke's new workout to help transform your body. On the back, it's Brucekins gives it a thumbs up.
So if I, God rest his soul. So if I do this, I will look like, are you saying
Guaranteed.
I will transform into Brooke Burke?
Definitely, yeah.
I will do this.
Me too?
I will watch
Me too.
This every day.
Both of you.
I don't know that. I mean, she's lovely, but I'm
very excited about this whole thing. Yeah. Okay, it's time for Daily Dial Trivia.